After that deadly high school shooting in Michigan, tonight the prosecutor now revealing new details on how the 15-year-old suspect allegedly obtained the gun that had just been purchased by his father on Black Friday. And tonight here, the faces of the four students who were killed, seven others injured, one student still in critical condition. And the growing focus on the gunman's own parents. Could they now face potential charges? ABC's Trevor Ault from Michigan tonight.
Tonight, as the Oxford High School community mourns, the Oakland County, Michigan prosecutor now revealing new details to us about how the suspect allegedly accessed the weapon his father bought on Black Friday and used it to gun down fellow students.
I think the evidence you'll see in the near future suggests that it wasn't that he didn't have to work that hard to get it. There are cases throughout the state and the country where a weapon's been left out and a child gets a hold of it and uses it to injure or kill somebody. And those individuals have been charged with very serious crimes.
The suspect's parents met with school officials the day of the shooting after two separate teachers reported concerns about his behavior, but he was allowed to return to class. In the wake of the shooting, schools in Michigan now hyper-vigilant, more than 60 canceling classes today. At one school in nearby Southfield, a 17-year-old who allegedly had a loaded gun in his coat pocket turned in Wednesday by another student.
That's a message of exactly what we're asking for. If another student turned him in.
And overnight, a vigil remembering the four victims killed. Tate Meir, Hannah St. Juliana, Madison Baldwin, and Justin Schilling. They played this video of Meir speaking after a football game.
This is where we live. Rain is just like after football. Tough, muddy, everything about us is tough.
Tonight, there's a movement to name Oxford's football stadium after him.
And David, the prosecutor is now reviewing potential charges for the parents of the shooting suspect after he allegedly got access to that weapon inside their home. She hopes to make an announcement within the next 24 hours, David.
Trevor Ault from Michigan tonight. Thank you, Trevor.